This is a little daunting, it might seem, is to remove this thing, but I've actually found it to be pretty dang convenient. I took it off when I installed the HIDs for the first time, and this time it's going to be a lot easier because I just don't have to figure anything out. Now, first thing you do is you got to take this little rubber piece off. Tab here for a deflector. I just grab my needle nose pliers and do a little pull like that. Next thing is to remove the 10 millimeter bolts. Little bolts right there. Okay, that's four. Is that all? Yep. That's all there is to it. So now it's only held on by some spring clips down the bottom. Let me get you a look at those. I hope you can see the little clips that are down in here. There's five of them. And I'm going to just move my screwdriver down there. And you just press down on that little spring clip. So take a look at it as I just press. It's going to release from there. Let's just continue on past, go to all of them. It's a little tight reaching down in there. See, there's two more clips there. One, or that's four, and that's number five. Once they're all unclipped, you just slide it off, just like that. Massive grill, beautiful piece of work. One push-in bolt holding in that air deflector, four 10 millimeters, and then five spring clips. Put it off the side, and I'll show you what this looks like with everything exposed up front. Okay, there's the exposed front end of the truck. I actually really like that. The access is amazing. Really easy to get to. I'm just going to pull out a few bugs while it's here. I'm going to put the grill back on. Like that. Okay, we'll put that little push pin back. We'll get the four bolts. That's it. It's all back together.